When I'm for more on the release of the Dapchi Girls, journalist Chika Odua joins me live via Skype from Dakar, Senegal. Good evening, Chika.
Hi, good evening. Yes. Good to be here.
Now, the big question here is how were these girls released? What do we know about it that perhaps was missed in the last time when the Chibok girls were released, were kidnapped, rather?
Well, so far we know that negotiations were brokered between the Nigerian government and this faction, this Boko Haram faction, which is said to be an ISIS affiliate. We know that there was no military force used because the president, Nigerian President Muhammadu Buhari, says that he didn't think that military force would be a good option. I think that what happened here that didn't happen clearly a few years ago in Chibok was that, number one, the president was quick to acknowledge that a kidnapping had taken place. In the case of Chibok, it took weeks before the Nigerian president at the time could actually admit that girls were kidnapped. Back then, there was so much speculation and suspicion around this. But in this case, the president acknowledged it within a few days, and he directed his defense forces, air team, to come and look for these girls. So I think just that leadership, it happened right away. And that didn't happen with the Chibok girls.
Now, you've spoken to some of the parents of these kids. Can you share with us their emotions? And what are they saying regarding the security of that area?
They're overwhelmed. I think that they're overwhelmed with joy because just a few days ago, the parents of the Chibok girls had advised the Dapchi girls, the parents of the Dapchi girls, to be patient. So they were hearing, just be patient, be patient. We've been waiting, you know, for a long time, so this is what it's going to be like. It has become the status quo in Nigeria for girls to be missing because many, many girls have been abducted by Boko Haram and many never returned. So the parents of the Dapchi girls had resorted to just waiting. So for this to happen so unexpectedly soon, really, it's just an overwhelming feeling that the parents are still grappling with and trying to make sure that this is real. They've been touching their daughters, according to what they told me, just to make sure this is real. So it's a beautiful feeling all around.
While they feel that great, talk about the others in that region, given that it looks like Boko Haram can strike at any time. What do they feel about the government's ability to protect them and their children?
They totally feel unprotected, the people of northeastern Nigeria, which is why they are relying less on the government to protect them. The Dapchi school has been permanently closed by the government. So while this is good news for the parents of the Dapchi girls, this is bad news for education because more parents are going to pull their daughters and their sons out of schools. So we have to wait to see what actually happens. Will schools be more secured? Because right now we're seeing that schools in northern Nigeria are not secured as properly as they should be.
Real big challenge there. Chika, thank you very much for your excellent reporting.
Thank you.
That's journalist Chika Odua reporting for VOA from West Africa.